Edward was the manager of the Beverly Cardinals Drum and Bugle Corps, and this is a piece of their routine from 1971. Thank you.
must I explain? I need you, oh my darling, like roses need rain. You ask how long I'll love you. I'll tell you true, until the 12th of never, I'll still be loving you.
This music you're listening to now is from the Beverly Cardinals Drum and Bugle Corps, which of course Ed was the manager of.
Today, my oldest brother Edward died from natural causes. He was 80 years old. Let me tell you a little bit about my brother. I'm just going to tell you what my brother Edward was like to me. I can go back in my memory and think about some of the things that occurred as we were younger. And we thought that, you know, it wasn't fair that certain things happened around us. But as I grew older and realized the truth, and the truth was that when my father died in 1956 from a massive heart attack, my brother Edward was 16 years old. My brother Philip was 9 years old. My brother Tom and I, twins, were 7 years old, and my little brother David was 2 years old. So at that very moment, my oldest brother became a man. he had dreams just like everybody else. You know, he wanted to be a merchant marine. He was a Sea Scout / Sea Explorer, which is part of the Boy Scouts at the time. He took over as head of household to keep the family together. Now, I had some wonderful aunts and uncles that I'm sure helped my mother during her times of need. But without Edward with us as a family, I do not believe that we would have stayed together as a family unit. And I'm not saying that my uncles and aunts or our godparents would take on the responsibility of raising us, and I'm sure my mother would not have allowed that. But under the circumstances, Edward had to take over as the head of household, and it was not easy for him either. Thank you, baby, for hitting the camera. And one more time. Edward's whole life changed. His dreams were gone. He was a Sea Scout / Sea Explorer. And he always wanted to be a merchant marine. But that didn't happen. When my father died, all of his dreams and planning had come to a complete halt. So here we are, 16 years old, a kid in high school, working two jobs, plus graduating, just to help my mother put food on the table, clothes on our backs, and a roof over our head. I know that my mother was receiving Social Security from all her children and herself because of the fact that she was so young and we were so young when he passed away. But it didn't change things in regards to the family unit. Edward was kind of the glue that held us together. Of course, you know, brothers have spats and arguments and disagreements. That's not unusual. And we had ours, don't get me wrong. We had some pretty zingers, if you know what I mean. Really whoppers. But as we grew older, we became accustomed to Edward being the head of the household. As a matter of fact, my little brother David thought Edward was our father because he was two when Eddie passed away. I mean, when my father passed away. So it was a rough time for us, but we always managed to make it. And with that being said, Philip, myself, and Tommy went into the military. Edward was exempt because he was head of household. And David was on the lottery, but they never called his number up when the Vietnam conflict ended. Anyway, while we were gone, I would met and fell in love and married Anne Marie. I'm not going to try to pronounce her last name. But over the years, Edward was always kind to me, so was Anne Marie. And I remember in 2008, when I had open heart surgery here in Dallas, I had called Edward up the night before surgery to let him know that I was going under the knife for, you know, quadruple bypass surgery. And then I wanted to let him know that in case something happened, that's what was going on. He asked me, do you want me to come down there? And I said, no, it's okay. I don't know. I just want to give you a heads up. When I came out of recovery room and opened my eyes, he was the first face I saw leaning over me. And I remember when they pulled the tube out, I asked him, I said to him, well, I guess there's no fat jokes today, huh? And he laughed and said, no. When I needed Edward, he was there for me in many different ways. I'm not going to go into those, what he had done to help me over the years, but I loved Edward and I loved Anne Marie. And they really, really were great to me. looks like we have a battle in the house with the two kitties, the two pooty cats. So this is just a little tribute that I put together to give you an idea what Edward was like. When I was 17, 18, somewhere around there, Edward became a committee member of the St. Mary's Cardinals Drum and Bugle Corps, and he traveled with us. And then in 1969, I went into the service, and the corps disbanded because of some conflicts between the church and the diocese and the corps itself. So the Beverly Cardinals were formed, and my brother Edward was the manager of the drum corps. And you'll see a couple of those, especially the battle hymn melody during the tribute that at the beginning of this program is about Edward. That was my kind of tribute to him, because he was a good manager, according to what my brothers were telling me. My brother David, he was under Edward's management as at the court at that time with the Cardinals. Then over the years, I go home on leave or go up to visit Tommy and David, and always manage to hook up with Edward and go out to get something to eat or just spend time with him just to shoot the breeze. One time he had come to, when I was in the Air Force, he had come to Washington, D.C. And I took my leave while he was there. And every day we went and did something. We did the monuments, we did the museums, and then after a couple of days I said, hey, what would you really like to see? What would you really like to do? Well, he was a big Civil War buff. So he said, I'd like to go to Fredericksburg, I'd like to go to Antietam, I'd like to go to Gettysburg. Well, being in Maryland, Fredericksburg's not too bad. Antietam is not too bad as far as the drive, but Gettysburg is a pretty good ride away. But we did a trip every day that, before he went back to Boston area. Anne Marie was the president of the Massachusetts Teachers Association or union, and she was in there for a conference, and he was just down there for the ride, so we went out and did some exploring, and we came across a lot of cool stuff. Antietam, Fredericksburg, they told that wall, the Stonewall Jackson wall, you hardly could see it anymore. It's just a few inches high, and it's all, modern stuff all around it, but it gives you a sense of what it was like back then. But Antietam was probably the best tour that we went on. It was really cool. A lot of history up there, as you can tell, both with the Civil War and also the Revolutionary War. So we did spend a lot of time together when we could. When he died a year ago today, it hit me hard. It really did. And I'm a softie. Always have been a softie, and my emotions are very, very easily erupted. And that's my mother's side of me. I got my mother's genes, if you want to say that, because of what's going on with my body personally, physically, and also with the way that things bother me. And I cry easily, and I shouldn't, but I do, and I just can't help myself. That's the way it is. So I want to thank John Beck for helping me with the video. He's a good friend of mine. And I'm sorry for the quality of the video, but all I had was some old stuff and pictures that I took pictures of. So when I was home in October of 20, I took some pictures of a bunch of old photo albums of my brothers with Edward. And that's what we put that video together with. So I just wanted to put a few minutes out there to let everybody know. Edward may be gone, but he's not forgotten. And I really miss him. I miss Anne Marie. And Anne Marie has had a stroke the day before Edward died, and she's been in some kind of a nursing facility ever since. So I just wanted to put this little video together. That's why my way of showing everybody the life of my brother. A lot of those memories are just kind of fragmented. I can't remember a lot of actually what happened. Just, I guess, the things that really hit you, I remember those. But anyway, I want to thank you guys for watching this video. And that I just want everybody to know my feelings I had for my brother Edward. I'll catch y'all later. Thanks for watching. Edward DuBois, rest in peace.